Hello everyone, my name is Abdulrazak Kharrabi. I'm a first year PhD student at the University of Liège. The paper I'm presenting is called Markerless Mobile Augmented Reality for Massive 3D Point Cloud and Semantic. This work was supervised by Professor Roland Bilin and Florent Pox. First of all, I will introduce the context of this work and goals to be achieved. I will continue by the development methodology, then its implementation, and to finish, I will present the results, discuss them, as well as show the direction of future work based on the new challenge we raised. So, let's start with mobile augmented reality. In fact, it essentially consists of superimposing virtual elements over real objects to give added information and enrich the interaction with reality without distracting us from the real world. Recently, mobile augmented reality attracts significant research and development efforts from both the industry and academia. The emergence of dedicated AR devices, video see-through or optical see-through such as your phone, HoloLens or Magic Leap, and the powerful software development kit like AR Core for Android and AR Kit for iOS, aided by new sensor integration and advances in computer vision, all this has fueled the development of mobile augmented reality and accelerated its adoption. The goal is to open on new AR application. In this paper, we investigate new way to better integrate massive 3D datasets and semantics throughout a web-based mobile AR application. And the challenge is that with the usual process, in order to reach more users, an AR application needs to go throughout repeated development cycles to accommodate different platforms, which undoubtedly increase the cost of development and deployment. For this, the web AR provisioning solution has gradually attracted developers' attention again due to the ever-increasing development of user devices and mobile network has emerged as a promising direction for mobile augmented reality. Our methodology is subdivided into three main parts, each of them covering several subparts as illustrated in this figure. The first part covered the point cloud processing, starting with segmentation, then classification into specific classes, and then structuration in an octree format for the purpose of real-time visualization. The second part concerned the creation of an immersive session. It began with the verification of the compatibility with the device, with the specification of augmented reality, then the estimation of the pose of the device based on the sensors, then the detection of characteristic points that constitute a planar surface, which is used for encoding the point cloud. The last one is the visualization and an interaction step. It consists of an iterative verification of the different nodes of the octree which are present in the user's field of view, and sends a request to the remote server for their loading and encoding in the encode point chosen by the user. So, first, segmentation was done semi-automatically on Cloud Compare, assisted by the following automatic plugins: Ranzac Shape Detection, CSF based on the Cloud Simulation Filter, Histogram Filtering, Label Connected Component, and Canopo. In classification step, we assigned for each created segment a specific class pointer. And since our objective is to show the possibility of visualization of massive point cloud in AR, the segmentation and classification precision evaluation step did not carry much importance in this process. Third step is the process of structuration. The main purpose of a data structure is to permit an easier and better access to underlying data. As such, we orient ourselves by spatially indexing massive point cloud based on a PoTree's octree data structure for real-time purposes. PoTree use a variation of the modifiable nested octree structure with a different subsampling method and a partition of the hierarchy into smaller, quickly streamable chunks. This is the typical AR process we used. First, the camera and other type of sensor are used to continually gather user ambient information. The environment perception based on computer vision algorithm analyzes the captured information for real-world recognition and perception. In the meantime, the user interaction information is additionally gathered by the sensor, then analyzed for tracking objects. Both the result of the perception of the environment and the interaction are used for a seamless integration of virtual content with the real world, which means a rendering operation is performed after which the AR is presented to the user. Normally, a typical AR Implementation mechanism can be sensor-based, vision-based, or hybrid methods. This implementation mechanism differ in terms of computing, networking, and storage. First, the sensor-based method could be a relatively lightweight mobile augmented reality implementation approach, while the vision-based approach places high demand on the computing and storage capability of the runtime platform, furthermore as network capability. The hybrid tracking mechanism is clearly a compromise solution between both the first and the second solution, and we based our approach on this implementation mechanism. Next step is to proceed to the web-based augmented reality implementation with the JavaScript 3.js and the WebXR API. 3.js provides three main things: scene, camera, and a render function. WebXR API, its goal is to detect if AR capabilities are available, query the AR device capabilities, pull the AR device and associate input device state, and display imagery on the AR device at the appropriate frame rate. The code is done in JavaScript based on several scripts which allow reading the file cloud.js, which contain the metadata, the .hrc files containing the hierarchy, and the .bin files which contain the node in binary format. Indeed, this process begins with the opening of an immersive session in augmented reality via an AR button, which allows to launch the camera to detect the surrounding environment. Then, a head test script is launched to allow making a recast with the detected planar surface to encode the 3D point cloud. After that, a search is done in the octree to find the nodes which are in the field of view of the camera, so that these nodes are loaded progressively from the hosting server. Each point is associated with a point cloud material that can either be its value in RGB intensity or a color that corresponds to the identifier of the class to which it belongs. Moreover, to have a shape more flexible, each point is made in the form of either square or circle with a variable pixel size according to the choice of the user. This implementation is based on a hybrid tracking mechanism and inside-out tracking. It is markerless method and computation outsourcing approach. The results of this work is a workflow allowing optimized management and display of massive 3D point cloud on a web-based AR without having either to install an application or having to store the 3D point cloud on your mobile device. Admittedly, web-based augmented reality remains very dependent on the internet, but it allows outsourcing of computation and data storage. So, mobile web AR deploys the sufficient computational resources of a server and the GPU accelerated rendering of WebGL API to accommodate its surface to the user's devices. As we can see in this test, in picture A, a window for the creation of augmented reality session, in B, head test to choose the anchor point, and C, the point cloud displayed in real color, and in D, the point cloud displayed in class's color. Promising results highlight a number of frames per second varying between 27 and 60 for a real-time point budget of 4.3 million points. The point cloud tested is composed of 29 million points and show how the indexation strategy permits the integration of massive point cloud in AR. The evaluation is carried out on a device with the technical characteristics which are summarized in the table. And after the test, we noticed a high consumption of the battery with a drop exceeding 10% per hour on the tested phone. In addition, we note a large delay at the start when loading the point cloud for the first time. In future work, we will investigate a more interactive user interface for better interaction. In addition, we will focus on the major challenge that arises when using web-based augmented reality, such as the network delay. We will study the effects of 5G on its improvement and minimization with higher bandwidth and lower network delay, which can certainly improve the data transmission on mobile network. Also, we will focus on the annotation and real-world alignment tools, support more spatial format like BIM, CAD, LiDAR, photogrammetry, and GIS, and also measurement and alignment tools. That is all for my presentation. I would like to thank you for your attention.